All right, what's going on, everybody? Broken Games HDR here. So in this video, I'm gonna give you my impressions from playing the Marvel Avengers beta. So this is a game that a lot of people were unsure about, right? Just based on, you know, our eye tests, just by looking at the game, the demonstrations and gameplay that we've seen, you know, hasn't convinced a lot of people. Everybody, you know, was just cautiously optimistic about the game. A lot of people thought the game looked mid and it would be disappointing and everything like that. But everybody just, most people were just unsure, right? And that's why I was excited to finally get to play it so I could, you know, know for sure if I like the game, if I'm gonna buy it or whatever. I can tell you right up front, I'm not buying this game, right? But that doesn't mean, I'm not saying it's trash though, is my point. The game isn't trash as I expected it to be, right? I didn't expect it to be trash, but I expected it to be just very average, very mid, right? That's what everybody thought. It would be a mid game. Maybe it would land in like the mid 70s, low 80s as far as like ratings and Metacritic goes and everything like that. And I still believe that, right? But see, it's not terrible. But it's not for me. I don't think it's that fun. And I'm gonna get into explaining it in a little bit more depth, right? So first of all, let me just say, the game actually looks pretty good. And this is obviously from the PlayStation 4 Pro. I have a beta code to play it on PC when the PC beta is live. I don't know if I'm gonna do that because, like I said, I don't like the game and I know I'm not gonna buy it, so there's not really any real reason for me to play it on PC, maybe just to upload a visual video. But yeah, I was surprised. I thought the game would look absolutely worse than it does. I think the art style is that they went with does complement the game, even though I disagree with some of the character designs, like most of us do, like with how Black Widow looks, how Iron Man looks, Tony looks, even Captain America. They all just look kind of weird. And you people make the argument that they did that to make these Avengers their own, Square Enix's own Avengers. They didn't want them to look like the Avengers necessarily that we're so familiar with. And all right, I guess you can go with that if you like. So by the way, I am playing in resolution mode. There's a resolution mode and there's a performance mode. Or they call it a 4K mode. I doubt that it's native 4K. It's probably checkerboarded, upscaled, and everything like that. But I played in resolution mode just so I can see the best the game could look. I am not sure if it runs at like 60. I doubt it runs at a lock 60 on performance mode. Maybe something unlocked or above 30, right? So, yeah, so the visuals are okay. They're definitely not terrible. The sound design is okay. Like when I was using Thor, for example, and hearing the sound effect that Thor's hammer, Mjolnir, makes while hitting enemies, it's like this kind of like, I don't know, it's like this dull thump. I feel like it could be a little bit more authentic and just crispier. It sounds kind of dull. But overall, like the atmospheric audio, I would say in the game in general, it sounds pretty good. It definitely doesn't sound terrible or weak, right? It has bass. It's robust, I would say. It's okay so far. You know, all those things, the visual sound design is okay. I was even impressed by the set pieces in the game, right? And the segment that you're looking at, this is the segment that we saw Square Enix show off a while ago, and like I said, playing through it is pretty cool. I like the set pieces and the level design and everything like that. And it's obviously a challenge to create a game around five characters, not even five characters, because they're gonna have more characters as the game progresses. They're gonna bring more characters, as we know, Spider-Man, Hawkeye, and there's gonna be more. So and I think that's what's actually going to be the downfall of this game. The fact that it's designed around so many different characters, it's gonna pretty much be a jack of all trades, master of none, right? That's the issue. This game isn't specifically designed for one character. And of course, you know, they're doing the best they can, given that it's an Avengers game, but versus a game where there is only one character, you can notice the difference of how enemies are designed and how the combat just naturally fits with those characters. Fits against that character. You get what I'm saying? Like, even though they do their best to create enemies that would go against a character like Tony, who has flight, who has a repulsor blast and everything like that, right? Or going against somebody who like Hulk, you would need to throw a lot of enemies at Hulk, or bigger enemies, more threatening enemies at Hulk to cater to his playstyle and so on and so forth, right? And once again, that's a difficult thing to do because the game can start to feel messy if you get what I'm saying, because it's not designed around a specific character. The world doesn't seem like it's very scoped in on what it wants to be, right? So, but moving on from that, the other thing I had like an issue with, and you might be able to see it, is like the combat feels kind of slow. And of course, as I said, each one of these characters have different play styles, as they should, because they are all very different type of heroes. But overall, it feels like the game is just very slow. The combat is slow, and the animations aren't as bad. The game definitely looks better than what we saw in the demonstration. Like I said, that Square showed us a while ago, right? It's the animations aren't bad, visuals aren't bad. The combat isn't as lame as it seemed just watching it. Not that it's so much better, but it's not as bad. But I can't say that it's fun either. I think that's my main problem with the game, and why I know I'm not buying it, is it's not necessarily fun to me, right? And I've always said, to me, if I don't like the combat in a game, nothing else matters, right? Because that's the core of what you do, right? That's one of the main things you do in the game. It's the combat. And if you don't enjoy the combat, you can't enjoy the game. And so playing with Iron Man, Hulk, Thor, Black Widow, and Captain America, the only two characters that I really enjoyed were, well, if I had to rank it, Captain America, best play style, best fighting style, best combat. He's the most fun to play. Right? And I think there was actually a Captain America game a few, like, last generation, and some people said it was pretty generic, but it wasn't terrible, I think. And even though it might be less variety to just have a basic, you know, a Captain America game, I'm not sure if anybody would necessarily believe that Captain America should get an entire game to himself, when you can offer much more heroes in one game than to create an entire game just for Cap. I can understand, like, that might not make the most sense, but I would say I would definitely buy it over this game. I would definitely play this game just for Cap and Black Widow, because those are really the only two characters that I like their fighting style, right? Because Cap is an actual technical fighter. He felt so like such a natural fit in this game, and it may be because his fighting style is similar to what we've played in other games like this, right? We typically don't play games with characters similar to like the Hulk's fighting style or Thor's fighting style, really. So Captain America just felt very natural, and I liked his fighting style. So it's the same with Black Widow. Both of them are very technical, you know, fighters, right? They're actual fighters, right? So yeah, I enjoyed them the most, and I did enjoy a little bit of Hulk. Hulk is obviously just a masher. H- Hulk is a button masher. He's just smash everything. And, you know, obviously that should be how he is. And you can get some cheap thrills from that. But to me, the fun of that died down very quickly. So, yeah, I mean, that's really all I have to say about the game. I just know it's not for me, because if it's a game where you have to play through this story and this campaign, and it's not something where you can just pick which character that you want to go through the whole game with, and I don't really enjoy the other characters, then I'm not going to enjoy the game. If you play the beta and you don't mind playing as Thor or Iron Man or Hulk and all of these characters, and you have to, and you also have to, like, every time you switch a character, you have to, like, switch up your play style, and it, because it's not like every one of the characters has the same button commands or the same button prompts, right? To do certain moves, some of the moves and the buttons are universal, like holding, like pretty much with all of them. If you hold square, they do an alternate square attack. If you hold triangle, they, you know, they do a heavy attack. Some things like that are universal, but other things are independent to those characters. So like I said, it's for me, I just know the game isn't for me because I don't like the play style of like 3 out of the 5 characters. They're just not fun to me. They're just not enjoyable. And like I said, this is a very, very, this is a very impressive set piece to me. But yeah, I like Black Widow and I like Captain America. But and I played a little bit past this part in the beta, but and I played as Hulk and all of that stuff a little bit more. And I'm like, yeah, if I have to, and I just knew, like, if I have to play as Hulk, and these other characters in the game, yeah, I'm not gonna like it, because just the little amount that I was playing with them, it was already starting to annoy me and just bore me. It was just saying, I was like going through the emotions while doing it. It just, you know, it just wasn't fun to me. It wasn't enjoyable. The flying with Iron Man, I don't know, it didn't really do anything for me. I'm gonna say this, and I don't think it's crazy at all. I think, not saying that Anthem is a better game, but I think the flying in Anthem is actually better than the flying that you do in this game with Iron Man. And a lot of people who played Anthem said that was like the closest you get to like an Iron Man simulator, even though there's technically like an Iron Man VR simulator. I don't know how that game is, but the flying in Anthem actually is better, and it feels more like Iron Man than Iron Man does in this game. So yeah, that's really what it is. I enjoyed the fighting between, you know, Black Widow and Cap, but that's it. It's cool because it's almost like experiencing an Avengers movie, you know, with the set pieces and the action and everything like that. And you know, I really do want to see some of the you know, the cool villains and who else shows up and appears in the game, as far as like, you know, metahumans. And you know, Taskmaster is like one of my favorite villains. You know, I just find everything about Task cool and everything like that. One of the, he's definitely become one of the, you know, the standout villains in like the last, I don't know, I would say 10 years. So I'm glad Tasky is getting his shine and everything like that. And I want to see what happens in the rest of this game, but I know I wouldn't be able to suffer playing through it. So yeah, those are my impressions. Let me know what y'all think. Follow me on Twitter if you're not. Hit the like button. Don't just take my word for it. Definitely try to play the beta for yourself. Just because I'm saying I don't like it and I'm not buying it doesn't mean you won't. So you should definitely try it out. My word ain't necessarily gospel. My opinion ain't gospel. I'm just telling you how I feel. So yeah, hit the like button, follow me on Twitter. Consider hitting the join button to become part of the channel, a member of the channel, and hit the notification bell so you can know anytime I upload a video. All right. So Yeah, that's about it. I'll catch y'all on the next video, alright? I'm out. Peace.
I'm done talking!
Coward!
What's the matter? Don't like surprises? Next time, take better notes. Guess you saw that coming, huh?
You think you've won?
What the hell are you talking about?
Look around, Romanoff. The world will remember this day. The day their heroes failed them.